What we're going to do now is start talking about the evaluation process, because you should be able to evaluate your program to determine whether or not this process is going too far or not far enough. And here's the evaluation process. There are three variables that you can use in your eval process, okay? The first one is going to be safety. The second one is going to be efficacy. And the third is efficiency. Okay? Safety. How many people make it to the finish line, or how many people are sidelined along the way? Efficacy is, what is the adaptation of the program? What are you going to get by doing the program? So, for instance, if I have a rope hanging program, in order to determine whether or not the program was efficacious or not, what had you better have the ability to do at the end of the program? Hang the freaking rope. That's how you determine that, right? The efficiency is, what is the time rate of the adaptation? How long does it take? And it should be pretty obvious that we want a decent balance between the two, just like we want over here. For instance, James has a pull-up program. It is $49.95. Don't know if you've seen it, but it's an infomercial. For $49.95, he is promising to get you 50 pull-ups. No matter where you are in the process, if you have 10, he's going to get you 50. If you've got 18, he's going to take you to 50, and he's going to do it in record time. 2 weeks. Anybody in here not want 50 pull-ups in 2 weeks? It's pretty awesome. For $49.95, I'd pay that all day. Here's a story, though. Of the 54 of you in here, 52 of you are going to die in the process. Okay? Yeah. And you see what happened there. Okay? So the flip side is this. Here's a story. Dennis looks at this thing, and Dennis goes, all right, I get it. $49.95 is a good price. People still loved getting the 50 pull-ups for that price. Here's the challenge, though. That risk right there is way too high. And I know there's enough A-types in here probably that are like, I kind of like those odds. Couple of you, Ray, you know, not so much. Yeah. Here's the story. Dennis makes his program 100% safe. You're not going to tear a callus. You're not going to twist a shoulder or an ankle on the way to 50 pull-ups. The only problem, though, is it's going to take you 52 years to get there. Okay. And hopefully what you see is what's happened here. We've ratcheted up the speed so fast that now the risk is not appropriate for the task. On the flip side of that, we've ratcheted up the safety so much that now the adaptation doesn't occur in any time frame that's going to be appropriate for what it is that you're trying to get accomplished. What we need is a program that sort of lands us right here in the middle. And ideally, that's where our program fits. The goal is, yes, people are getting more fitness now than they've ever gotten. We're doing pretty darn good there. We're doing pretty darn good and making sure that they get it in relatively quick time. Now, the challenges for us as coaches and as athletes is this. We have to make sure we minimize the risk, okay? And that means a slow process to getting people to this kind of adaptation, all right? Make no mistake, there's always going to be risk with what we do, but the goal is to make sure it's appropriate to the task that we're giving our athletes, okay?